Hello students, today we are going to start chapter number 17, circles. So first of all, what is circle? Circle is a set of points which moves in a plane in such a way that its distance from a fixed point is always constant. Their distance always constant from the fixed point. This is the center of the circle. Suppose center, this is called O. So now, what is center? Center of a circle is the point which is equidistant from all points on the circumference of the circle. This is the circumference of the circle and this is the center of the circle. And their distance from the center, from any side, it is equal. Next is the radius. The radius of a circle is the length of the line segment from center to the circumference of the circle. Next one is the diameter. This is a radius. And diameter is the longest chord that line segment passing through the center of the circle. This is called diameter. Pull the longest chord in a circle, it is called diameter. Next is the circumference. The distance around the edge of the circle is called circumference of the circle. Next one is the chord. A line segment inside a circle whose end points lie on a circle, this is called chord. Okay. Next one is the secant. A line which intersects the circle at two different points, this is called secant. Next one is the tangent. And tangent is a line which touches the circle at one point only is called tangent, and their distance, perpendicular distance, is 90 degree A B. This is called tangent. This is the circumference of the circle. Next is the arc. Arc of a circle. This is the center of the circle, and arc is a portion of the circumference of a circle. This is arc. This is the portion of the circumference of the circle. This is arc. And it is denoted by this symbol. Next, minor arc and major arc. The smallest portion is called minor arc and the largest portion is called major arc. This is the minor arc and this is the major arc. Next one is the semicircle. Half of the circle, half portion is called semicircle. This is the center. These are the two points. Next one is the sector of a circle. First of all, you have to draw a circle. This is the center of the circle. And sector is the part of a circular region enclosed by two radii of the circle and their intercepted arc. So this is the shaded portion is called minor sector and this is the major sector. Next one is the segment. segments are, a chord divides the circle into two parts. This is called as segments. And shaded portion is called minor segment. And this is called major segment. Next one is the anterior and exterior of a circle. The set of points whose distance from the center is less than the radius, or the set of points that lie inside the circle, is called anterior of the circle. Those points are inside of the circle that are called anterior of a circle, and which points are lie out of the circle, this is called the exterior of the circle. Okay, in this exercise you have need of a compass and a scale to draw a circle. For example, you want to draw a circle of 5 cm and measure the distance 5 cm from your scale. Suppose this is a scale and you have to draw a circle distance here. This is 5 cm. After that, take this as a circle, take compass and keep your compass here and take it as a center and draw the circle with the help of a compass. So with the help of this you can draw the circle of 5 cm. Firstly you measure with the help of scale 5 cm, 4 cm as it is, then you take it as a center of compass, and after that you have to draw the circles. Only this type of sums are in your exercise. Try to solve it. Thank you.